Hello friends, today in our YouTube channel I am going to start some topics in organic chemistry. And in organic chemistry, if you see, the name reactions are very popular, so we are going to cover some name reaction in our YouTube channel. So we are today going to start with the name reaction, that is Wolff-Kishner reduction. Wolff-Kishner reduction is a well-known reduction. Students from the 11th and 12th standard are learning the Wolff-Kishner reduction. Today we are going to learn something common and uncommon for the all the students from 11th, 12th to postgraduate student. Normally we are learning only reaction and its application, but today in this video we are going to discuss each and every detail of the Wolff-Kishner reduction, including the mechanism part also. So today we are going to start the Wolff-Kishner reduction, and myself, as you know, Dr. Gaurang Dubal, right? So welcome to our YouTube channel again, and this is the Wolff-Kishner reduction. So first we will see by principle. As we know, the Wolff-Kishner reduction is a reduction reaction. So the principle simply says that aldehydes and ketones can be reduced to the corresponding hydrocarbons. Corresponding to the hydrocarbons. What is the meaning of corresponding? The same number of carbon you find in aldehyde or ketone, the same number of hydrocarbon will be generated by the reduction reaction, right? And this reaction, conversion of aldehyde to ketone by particular reagent, the reagents are hydrazine and some base. Say for example, potassium hydroxide. So the hydrazine and potassium hydroxide, if convert aldehyde or ketone into the hydrocarbon, that is known as Wolff-Kishner reduction. Now we are going to see whatever we learnt in the words, right? So what is in the form of reaction? So next title is reaction. So now we are going to see, suppose we have any aldehyde or ketone. If you see, suppose you have one hydrogen in place of this R, right? So the formation of aldehyde will be there, RCHO, that is aldehyde, right? So that is one option, you can take aldehyde. Another option, suppose you have R, it means RCO and R. That is nothing but ketone. So it may be either aldehyde, it may be either ketone. Then you take anything, aldehyde or ketone, and just react with the hydrazine. So reaction with hydrazine will result into the removal of water, and you will get some imine-like formation over here. Conversion of ketone into the imine, right? And this imine, actually it is called hydrazide. So the actual name is hydrazide formation, but bond looks like imine, right? So the actually hydrazide formation is there, and this hydrazide finally reacts with the strong base, example KOH, right? So Wolff-Kishner reduction by help of hydrazine and KOH, we will finally get the alkane, or you can say hydrocarbon, right? Suppose you have ketone. So this carbonyl finally get converted into CH2, methylene, and as a result, you will get a concerned same number of carbon, hydrocarbon as a product, right? So that is all about the reaction. Now we will see the detailed mechanism of this reaction, right? So first we will put the title, that is mechanism, and now we are going to see this mechanism. how it's happened, right? So as I told you, we taken what? We taken either aldehyde or ketone here. We take aldehyde or ketone over here and reacted with this hydrazine. Hydrazine. So by that we will get the removal of water from here. One hydrogen, another hydrogen, and oxygen from the carbonyl, right? So here two empty bonds with carbon, here two empty bonds with nitrogen. So we will get the hydrazide formation. Actually it is known as hydrazones. Hydrazones. If you are using hydrazine, it will be hydrazone. If you are using phenyl hydrazine, that will be hydrazones, right? So formation of hydrazone will be there, right? And then after removal of water, we will get this structure. That is hydrazones, right? Okay. Now, if it is aldehyde or ketone, but this positions always remain same. Now, we are taking base. Base is which one? KOH. It may be KOH also, right? And other strong base can be used. But mostly it is preferred, people are using KOH. Right? So what will happen? The base always have electron and try to donate the electron. So here, the in presence of base, the bond between nitrogen and hydrogen will become polar. The bond between nitrogen and hydrogen will become polar. So electron will be donated or shifted towards the nitrogen. It will be shifted towards the nitrogen. And H may have positive charge. The positive charge will take electron from the base. So we will get removal of one molecule of water. How? OH from base and H from the NH. Right? So now the electron will shift it towards the nitrogen. So what will it will result into what? It will result into the electron present on the nitrogen, which generates negative charge, right? So this negative charge is not stable. So we wrote in a big bracket. Big bracket shows what? Transition intermediate unstable. It is unstable, right? So now the proton is removed with OH minus and we get this one. But due to the inductive effect, the electron will be donated towards this bond to the nitrogen and the electron further will shift to the carbon. Further shift towards the carbon. So now if the electron shifted of double bond electron is shifted towards the carbon, then the carbon may have negative charge. Carbon may have negative charge and a partial positive charge will be generated on the nitrogen, and between the two nitrogen, one partial negative and positive charge will generate a double bond over here, right? So formation of double bond will be observed here and anion will form here. Now this structure in presence of acid, in presence of acid, the H will take electron from this carb anion. It possesses electron, which is gained from the double bond, right? So this electron will be donated to the hydrogen, right? And the hydrogen will join with the carbon as a covalent bond, which is present over here, right? Now, what will happen? The electron will be donated to the nitrogen. And hydrogen may have positive charge. This bond's electron will be shifted towards the carbon, right? So this nitrogen may have little positive charge, this may have negative charge. So three bond will form between the nitrogen and nitrogen and it will be removed as the molecule of nitrogen, N2 minus, right? N2 will be minus. Now we have CH negative. So that is carb anion. Further the H plus, that is nothing if we have BH plus. BH plus means base. Base in place of that you can write water also, right? So water H plus will join with this and we may have minus OH minus. the catalyst we utilize will get from outside as it was added, right? And the H will join with the carbon, CH, right? As we know, that is CH over here, it will convert into, after addition of H, it will convert into CH2. So as we learnt in the reaction, the carbonyl get converted into the alkanes, or you can say hydrocarbon. It may be aldehyde also, it may be ketone also. Finally, the C double bond O will convert into the CH2, right? So that is all about the mechanism of this Wolff-Kistner reduction. And now we are going to see the application part of this reaction. So application part, what you have to focus, the number of carbon must remain same when you do the reduction. When you do the reduction, and carbonyl should be converted into methylene, right? Either in form of aldehyde or in form of ketone, right? See, so application part, first application we are going to see. See, number of carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. In 9 carbon, no name, second position, ketone, that is 2 nonane known. If you do the Wolff-Kistner reduction, the carbonyl will definitely get converted into the methylene. So we may have product nonane. From nonanone, we get nonane. Ketone converts into alkane or hydrocarbon, you, as you like, whatever you say, right? Next example, application, next one. That is, you have a compound, 4-phenoxyacetophenone, right? In this, if you see, where is your area of interest? That is ketone. Right? And if you see, the ketone is get converted into methylene. By the help of Wolff-Kistner reduction. So this example also shows that the carbonyl convert into the methylene and concern alkanes or substituted, whatever you have, right? Next. Complicated looking like structure is there, but actually it is simple, right? Here some stereochemical bonds are there, ester group is there, carbonyl group is there, but as we know, the Wolff-Kistner reduction will only affect to the carbonyl of either aldehydes or ketone, not to the esters, right? So first we are going to see the carbonyl on the second, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, fifth position, right? Carbonyl on the fifth position get converted into the methylene, So this is the third example for the Wolff-Kistner reduction. We will see another last example. So that is a compound having two-sided carboxylic acid, in middle we have a carbonyl. As we know, the carboxylic acid will not get affected by the Wolff-Kistner reduction, but the carbonyl will get affected, and only the ketone carbonyl, will get converted into the methylene, right? So this conversion also is an application of the Wolff-Kistner reduction. So you can take so many examples, you can watch in your textbooks, reference books, right? But the simple thing, Wolff-Kistner reduction reagents are hydrazine and KOH, and they are converting, the aldehydes and ketone into the concerned hydrocarbons, or you can say conversion of carbonyl into the CH2 methylene, right? So this is all about the Wolff-Kistner reduction. Thank you very much for listening to me patiently. Have a nice time. Thank you.